returned and just
hello
happened Hi. To step out at the right wrong moment. Luckily I was listening, so I get all the context before I make sure I don't miss anything. But that first one was referring to how in Glass Onion, and the three of you have mercifully not seen that film, yeah?
Or the other one.
So very important, super awesome hero main character gets shot almost in the heart at one point. You're like, oh no, dead. Turns out that, you know, the killer was trying to kill her too, but luckily she had a little notepad in her pocket and it blocked the whole bullet.
Oh, of course.
What? Yeah.
The notepad.
And
remember that YouTuber that was killed when his girlfriend shot him through a massive telephone directory?
Yeah, there's the thing. Obviously, Rags, our resident gun guy, was just like, bullshit.
Paper doesn't stop bullets, guys.
But the
little slivers of metal doesn't stop it either.
Yeah, well, Drinker points it out in his video, and the guy we covered on EFAB was like, well, you know, there are some notepads in the world that might have a metal plate in there.
Yeah, with a Desert Eagle, yes.
Is it platinum? Is it platinum in about a fucking inch thick? Maybe. So
that's that reference. The other one, fucking, is it Matthew
clear
Arnold?
Aluminum?
Aluminium?
Aluminium? Aluminium.
Thank you, Gary. That is correct.
Hey, that's the one word you got. I totally agree with you on. Aluminium. Just sounds cooler than aluminum.
Agreed. I'm glad
we
got
that in Farsi, too.
Go on, sorry.
What was the second one? I can explain that one too.
Tell that to Teddy Roosevelt. That's true.
Metal plates or something?
But that was like,
no, the metal plate was the first one. There was one that mentioned, was it Matthew Arnold? Matthew something? Matthew?
Hold on. Because
that's
down.
Funny as well.
Yeah, there's a couple of guys out there on Glass Onion. Man, Glass Onion.
The fax machine
triggered.
System is perfectly within character. It's quirky and dumb.
So this is so funny to actually say these things to you guys, because you have no context and you just have to believe me. I know it's true, but you guys have to
trigger. No, not liking Glass Onion triggered the locals, like, big time. Like, they fucking, like, I've never seen this many anti-drinker videos in my life than over fucking Glass
Onion.
Yeah,
no, he really pissed them all off, and it was so funny, because the best of them, so to speak, this video is so fucking bad. So, the main character, a lot of people say he's supposed to be making fun of Elon Musk, he's a tech billionaire who's an idiot, like, that is the plot, he is an idiot, it's just that everyone keeps saying it over and over again, he's so stupid, and everyone thought he was smart, haha. So, there's a lot of problems that can be created in the film if he had a phone, but he doesn't. This tech billionaire does not have a phone. Instead, he runs his entire billionaire operation, all of his companies, everything, everywhere, all over the world, with fax machines exclusively.
Why? Because he's got like some sort of quirk or something.
That is it. Okay. It's just he's just quirky. He only uses a fax machine, and it's part of his downfall. Is the heroes get to see sensitive information thanks to the fact that all of his fucking fax machines post everything he ever gets privately.
This sounds so fucking
good. So the guy who's so paranoid he won't use computers doesn't wipe the logs of his fax machine?
Gary, there's evidence that implicates him in the murder, and it's just in his little deposit for the fax machine shit. Like, you could just look. It's so bad. But yeah, this
is it
person,
like paper?
Yeah.
That he doesn't shred?
Nope.
But he's so paranoid he won't use a computer, but he won't shred the paper from the fax machine. Ryan Johnson is so smart. Am I
supposed to go that far?
He's gonna have a Star Wars.
He's got a big head to hold his big brain.
And then of course you have Drinker brings it up. It's just like, what the fuck is this stupid shit? And then the person was like, it's actually completely in character that a quirky person might only use fax machines.
I agreed, but he would shred all the fucking paper. He would wipe the logs, easy to do.
No. Let everyone see everything.
Wait. I have used fax machines at my work, and for proprietary information, we had to shred everything. Yeah. Everything.
I don't want to talk Glass Onion. Fuck it. We got shit to do.
Last thing for context of that super chat, right? Was, you know, you guys know Drinker. He sells himself on his channel as an incredibly intelligent, better than everyone person, doesn't he? It's not at all that he's like selling himself as a drunk who gives his thoughts on things. It was funny. I have to remind people this video sells him as like, oh, he's a guy who just thinks he's so fucking clever. Just like,
yeah,
he
his
talks
name
about
is the critical thinker, not the critical drinker. Come on, guys.
He talks about how he'll like go on benders that are nights long and just like end up in an alleyway
toilet duck.
Yeah, and stuff like that. It's just like, come on. he's pretentious. And then in like the same breath, this guy is like, ugh, critical drinker thinks this is cliche. It's like, I wonder what Matthew Arnold would have to say about that. And it just like shows this guy and all of us are like, who the fuck is that? Like, it's
like a... Who's Matthew Arnold?
Who's that? I don't get it.
And like all of chat were just fucking losing it. Like, who the fuck is that?
Not Matthew Arnold, no!
The Matthew Arnold.
The Matthew Arnold? My goodness.
Who's that?
I don't know.
Who?
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 I think we had a, yeah, it's like an English poet and cultural critic. There you go.
Is he a film director? Because there's a Matthew Arnold film director.
No, he was 1822 was when he was born, so I doubt he was a film director. But he's the son of Thomas Arnold. You know, you guys know Matthew Arnold.
What would Tom Arnold say about this?
Give me another line of Coke.
Give me some more Coke.
I thought he was married to Roseanne.
We need more Coke over here.
Short version is, if you want to have some fun, you have a spare 5 hours, I think it was, you can go check out that episode. We check out someone ripping some of the drinker.
It was pretty fucking funny, dude.
The funny part
video you were going over, that guy's got a lot of subs, right?
Well, that's part of why people really wanted us to see this video. It's over like 250,000 views, and it's just ripping at a drinker. And we were like, okay, fine. Yeah, we'll give it a shot. It's embarrassing. An entire building explodes and is set on fire, and he legit shows that shit, and then basically all the characters survive, and Drinker's like, how the fuck did they do that? And then he goes, nothing about this would be fatal to a human.
Nothing about a building blowing up with them blowing inside would be fatal to a human.
Glass flying at you at the speed of a bullet.
I can't even properly illustrate just how fucking retarded it is. If you type in glass onion explosion into Google Images, you'll see what it is. And
God, I need to watch these movies now.
I don't.
No.
You
please don't, Velma. Please don't make me as.
I was gonna say you fucking watch Velma, but not glass.
You
onion.
Take Velma.
Velma's 20 minutes long.
You take.
Yeah,
Velma,
but you said you watched the whole season. If people watch you watching it, so
yeah, because at least I'm doing it in 20-minute intervals.
Fine.
Every
do
week.
Glass onion in 20-minute intervals.
That's like
38
seconds.
Fuck it. I can't remember. I don't even know if you guys know. They destroy the Mona Lisa in that film, and it's supposed to be a good thing.
Why?
Well, so
kill the past. Kill the past. That's the symbolism. That's why I gotta watch this.
It's kind of even worse. They kill the Mona Lisa, so to speak, because the apparently supposed to be Elon Musk character, it's like his prized possession.
It's Elon Musk, and it's all the. It sounds like Rian Johnson. Like, we live in his head from Last Jedi, and he's just writing a murder mystery to work out his fucking hang-ups of so many fans.
Gary, there is a Twitch streamer who tends to write the right wing, and he shoots everything.
No.
Like I said, I'm surprised you guys wouldn't want to check out this movie. It's fucking abysmal.